in the educational session today, I discussed what actually could be the best combination for novel agents. We have a lot of data on ibrutinib single agent. We have data on venetoclax, and we're getting trials now on either venetoclax ibrutinib, venetoclax obinutuzumab, and the same is true for ibrutinib with venetoclax or with an antibody. So we discussed that for venetoclax, one of the mechanisms could indeed be in mutations in BCL2, which was covered by Leslie Ann in the second educational talk today. I discussed more that within the microenvironment, cells get increased expression not only of BCL2, but also of additional anti-apoptotic molecules like BCL-XL, BFL1, MCL1, and that we didn't really show that, but actually what you see from the monotherapy trials, or also from the Murano trial, is that the clearance of blood and bone marrow seems easier with venetoclax than the lymph node, which actually confirms that indeed in the lymph nodes, cells are more resistant, probably due to this tumor microenvironment where they get this induced expression of these molecules. And therefore, I think, to come back to the earlier trial, is that it's very interesting to combine venetoclax and ibrutinib, because as venetoclax is really an agent very potently inhibiting BCL2 in the blood and marrow, but less so in the lymph nodes. But if you combine it with ibrutinib, where you chase the cells out of the lymph nodes, then that could actually be synergistic in theory.